Hi dear students, welcome to Geeta's classes. Now we are going to see the topic connectivity of graphs in discrete mathematics. So what do you mean by connected graph? In the graphs, whether there it is connected or not. So before that we should know what is reachability. If you are having a vertex, a graph G, in that a vertex V in a simple graph is said to be reachable. From a vertex U of G, if there exists a path from U to V. For example, if you consider A, B, C, D and E, F. So B is reachable from A. You can find out the path from A to B. C is reachable from A. A, B and B, C. Okay, so we can find out the path. Path means what? You have to start from one vertex and travel along the adjacent edges, okay, which is incident with that. So, with the through the adjacent vertices, you have to go and reach the other vertex. Then it is said to be reachable. So, this is E reachable from A? No. You cannot find a path. You up to B and up to D only you can go, okay. So, I cannot reach E. E is not reachable from A. F is not reachable from B. But A is reachable from B, A is reachable from C, C is reachable from A. If you can find a path, then it is called reachable. So, set of vertices which are reachable from the given set, given vertex V is called reachable set. So, what is reachable set of A, R of A? It is denoted by R of B. So, which are all the vertices which are reachable from A? B, comma C, comma D. Okay. What is R of E then? It is only F. Only F is reachable from E. Okay. So, what is the reachable set of B? A, C, D and so on. Okay. That is the reachable set. Next is connectedness in undirected graphs. So, a graph is connected if it is possible to travel. What about this graph G? G, it has two components. E is not reachable from B. Therefore, it is not connected. Okay. Every pair, any two vertices if you consider, one vertex should be reachable from the other vertex. Okay. So, a graph is connected if it is possible to travel from any vertex to any other vertex along a sequence of adjacent edges of the graph. Adjacent edges in the sense, it should be incident with that vertex. Okay. Through the edge, you should be able to go to the adjacent vertex. So, thus a graph G is connected if given any vertices V and W in G, there is a path from V to W. That is, if any pair of vertices are reachable from one another, this is important. If you consider any two vertices, you should be able to reach from one to the other one. Here we have seen E is not reachable from B. Therefore, the graph G is not connected. Okay. So, if you remove this E and F, it is connected. Right. And these two are called components. This is now, so this graph G contains two components, two connected components. All the each and every, if you are talking about the components, every component should be connected graph. Okay. So, a graph which is not connected is called a disconnected graph. A disconnected graph is the union of two or more connected subgraphs. So, this is a subgraph. This is a subgraph. A, B, C, D is one subgraph. E and F is another subgraph. Okay. So, the disjoint connected subgraphs are called connected components of the graph. Now, let us see some more examples. Can you say, I'll give you some graphs, you can imagine, we can guess whether it is a connected graph or not. A, B, C. Is it connected? Yes. As it is connected. If you have one more, D, E, F. Now, this is not connected. Okay. If you consider only the first one, now how many components are there in this? Two connected components are there. Okay. This is our G1. What about G2? A, B, C, D, E, F. Is it connected? It looks connected, but they are not connected. Okay. You have how many components in this? A, B is one component. Actually, what is the definition? If you consider A and E, are they reachable from each other, one another? No, A cannot be reached through from E, right? Actually, this is a this is called cross vertex. Okay, it is called crossover. This is called crossover. Sorry, this is called crossover. It is not a vertex. We don't have a vertex in this, right? This is just they are crossing each other. These two edges are crossing each other, but we don't have a vertex in this. Okay, there is no vertex in this. So it is not a connected graph. Okay, so AB is an edge and CD is an edge. Therefore, how many components are there? One AB is one component, CD is one component, EF is another component. Okay, so there are three components in this graph. So it is not connected. This is also not connected. Suppose if I join these two, B and D. Now it is a connected graph. This is connected. Understood? So connected means if you consider any two vertices, you should be able to reach from one another. Okay. Then cut vertex and cut set. Cut vertex, from the name itself, you can remember easily, you can understand easily. You can tell whether it is cut vertex or not. A cut vertex or cut point of a connected graph G is a vertex whose removal increases the number of components. Okay, components means each component should be connected. Okay, similarly, cut edge, or actually if you remove one vertex, it should increase the number of components that should be disconnected, that should get disconnected. Okay, cut edge or bridge, similarly in the same way here, cut vertex we have seen, no, here cut edge or bridge is called. If by removing some edge, if the number of components is increasing, then it is called cut edge or bridge. Okay, and set of all minimum number of edges of G whose removal disconnects a graph G is called the cut set of G. I'll give you some example, you will understand clearly. Okay, suppose if I consider this graph, you have G1, A, B, C, D, E, F and G. Can you tell me which are all the cut vertices? What about A? Actually, if I remove, is it a connected graph? Yes. How many components are there? One component is there. Okay. Now, if you remove A, what will happen? Only if I remove A, I'll show you. If I remove A, again it is connected. Number of components is one only. Nothing is changed, right? So A is not a cut vertex. This edge is also not a cut edge. Okay. What about B? If I remove B, what will happen? You will have A. Right? Is it a cut vertex? Can you say B is a cut vertex? Yes, we can. Because this is a simple null graph. You have one. It is N1. Right? Null graph with one vertex. It is. Now this is one component. This is another component. Yes, B is a cut vertex. Okay. What about C? If I remove C, you will get three components. Okay. D is alone and AB and EFG. You will have three components. So number of components is increased. What about E? E is a cut vertex. F is a cut vertex. G is not a cut vertex. D is not a cut vertex. What about this edge C, E? It is a cut edge. If you consider only C, E, it is an edge. This is cut edge. Now, minimum number by which you can remove this. If you remove this, how many minimum edges are to be removed? That set will call, the set is called the cut set. This is a cut set. Okay, E, F. This is also a cut set. If you remove this, it will be increased by, the number of components will be increased. Okay. So it is a cut set and so on. If I consider this, consider another graph, A, B, this is C, D, and you have E, this is also joined, F. Can you tell me the cut set here? If is A a cut vertex? No. B is not a cut vertex. D is not a cut vertex. Right? C is not a cut vertex. E. If you remove E, it will be a cut vertex. Only cut vertex is E. Okay? This is cut vertex. What about cut edge? single, if you remove this EF, then it is not removing, okay? So minimum you have to remove C comma D, then B comma D, and C comma E, you can see. So minimum, this is a concept. If you remove this H, I'll show you. BD, CD and CE. What will happen now? See, if you remove EF, that means you are removing this F also, okay? So that is that vertex will also be removed. But here, if you remove this H, B and D vertices will not be removed, okay? So here, G, C, comma. If you remove, now we got the two components, okay? Two different, connected sets, right? So two components, the number of components is increased by one, okay? Therefore, it is a cut set. So minimum number of edges to be removed. It need not be unique, okay? Instead of CE, I can remove D, comma E also, okay? So it is not, it need not be unique. You can find out your own way of removing the edges, okay? Next is connected digraphs. These are all undirected graph we have seen. Now it is connectedness in digraphs. See, there are three types. One is weakly connected or simply connected. Next is unilaterally connected, strongly connected. I have told you already, from the graph theory is very, very easy. From the name itself, you can understand and keep it in your mind. Okay. Weakly connected means without direction. You can, it's simply a connected graph. Okay. If you remove the arrows, it should be connected. Then it is weakly connected. That is, from one vertex, you need not go to the other vertex. It need, all the vertices are need not be reached from the reachable from the other vertices. Okay. So your digraph is called a weakly connected if it is connected as an undirected graph. If you remove the arrows, it should be connected. Then it is called weakly connected. I'll give you one example, you can understand easily. Unilaterally connected means if you consider any two vertices, at least one vertex should be reachable from the other vertex. Okay. So a simple directed graph is said to be unilaterally connected if for any pair of vertices, at least one of the vertices of the pair is reachable from the other vertex, then it is said to be unilaterally connected. Then you can imagine now itself, now I think you might be knowing the definition of strongly connected. In both the sides, if you consider any pair of vertices of the graph, both the vertices of the pair are reachable from one another. Okay, you should be able to reach from one another. Next is, I'll give you an example. You tell me whether it is strongly connected or weakly connected or unilaterally connected. Here this is A, B, C and D. The arrows, it is strongly connected, unilaterally and weakly connected are defined for directed graphs, okay? And here, these are the directions, okay? First you consider A. From A, are you able to reach B? Yes. Are you able to go to C? Yes. Are you able to go to D? Yes. Is D reachable from A? Yes. I can go to B and you should be able to find a path, right? So AB, then BD. Yes. B is reachable from A. C is reachable from A. D is reachable from. So if you consider A comma B, this is one side. So you I can say that it is unilaterally connected. The other way also is B, A comma B was over, A comma C, okay. A comma B, from B are you able to reach A? Consider one by one, A comma B. A is reachable from B or not? B, from B you can go to D and A. Yes, it is reachable. A comma C. C is reachable, B is reachable from A is reachable from B. What about A is reachable from C or not? Yes. From C, you have to go to B, BD, then CB, BD and DA. It is C is reachable, A is reachable from C. C is reachable from A also. So, it is accepted. Yeah. It is satisfied. So, A comma D. From D, you are able to go to A. What about from A? Yeah, A to B, A, B to D. Yes, this is also right. Then, what are the other combinations? B comma C. From C, yes, you can reach B. From B, you can go to D and come to C. Yes, this is also accepted. Then B, D. B, D. From B, you can go to D. And from D, you can go to B. Yes, this is also both the sides, they are reachable from each other. B, D is over. Next is C, D. C, D. From D, yes, you can come to C. And from C, you can come to B, then D, then A. Yes, C, sorry. C to D, no? So C to B, B to D. Yeah. This is also satisfied. Any other possibilities? Yeah, only this much, right? So AB, BC, CD, AD. Yeah, AD is over. Yes, all are over. So every pair is reachable from each other. Therefore, it is strongly connected. Therefore, this graph is strongly connected. Okay. Next, I'll give you one example for each one. I have to give one example. Okay. So, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, 4 to 3. This is the direction. Okay. If you consider 1 and 2, now let us see, one by one. If you consider 1 and 2, from 1 you can go to 2, from 2 you cannot come back, okay. 2 and 1 and 3, 1 and 3 you can't even go, from 3 also you cannot come to 1. So here itself, okay, what about if you remove the arrows? Even one side also it is not satisfied. So, if you remove the arrows, it is a connected graph. Therefore, it is weakly connected. Understood? Yeah. Next is, because if you consider 1 and 3, from 1 you are not able to go to 3. No, 3 is not reachable from 1 and 1 is not reachable from 3. So, it is not at all possible. Therefore, but if you remove the arrows, it is connected. Then it is weakly connected. Okay. So, even after removing, if it is not connected, it is the disconnected graph. Right? So, next is 1, 2, this is 3, 4, and here from 3 to 4 if I, so if 1 comma 2, what are all the possibilities? 1, 2 is reachable from 1, 1 is not reachable from, so one side, 1 is reachable, 2 is reachable from 1, one side is fine. Then 1 comma 3, three to four and four to one. Yeah, one is reachable from three. Okay. But three is not reachable from one. Okay. Then one comma four, four to one, it is reachable. One to four, it is not possible. So only one side. So one comma four. What about now consider two? Two comma three. From three, you are able to go to two. Two to three, it is not possible. And two comma four. From 4 through 1, you can come to 2. So, one side it is possible. 2 to 4, you cannot. Okay. Then 3 comma 4. Yeah, 3 to 4, it is possible. So, one way it is possible. Therefore, it is unilaterally connected. Okay. So, we have seen connected graphs. It is over. Next is planar graphs. We will see in the next class. Thank you so much for listening.